Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. And a very good day to you. So, today we're going to continue our discussion from in this subject MGSG 1114, Principle of Geographic Information Science. So, this discussion is on the chapter 5. So, in this chapter, we're going to discuss on the method on data input, spatial data input, and then the editing part, what the method in editing part that they have, and then lastly the importance of integrated databases in GIS. Okay, so the name of this chapter, the topic of this chapter is data input and editing, and I put a little bit on data integration database. So the content of our discussion today is, the first one is on the introduction, and then the methods of data input. The third one is data editing. The fourth one is geocoding address data. And lastly is a conclusion. Right. So before we start our discussion, there's some question to ponder. Okay, what is the data stream? What is data encoding? How to encode the data? And then what methods of data encoding are available right now? How are paper map digitized? What problem are faces when encoding digital and analog data? And then what next? What methods of data editing and conversion are used in GIS? Okay, and lastly is, how is an integrated GIS created? So this is some of the questions that we will answer throughout this topic. Okay, so as we know, in GIS we not only have one source of data, we have so many type of data input, from satellite data, from field data survey, from the questionnaire that we ask people, and then from the GPS maybe, and then from data from other information such as from Department of Statistics, from Department of Survey and Mapping, and so on. So we have so many type of the spatial data. Okay, how to insert this all this data into our system or our application that we're going to develop? So that's the question that will be answered throughout this topic. Okay, so GIS have many data sources, as I already discussed. So we have different format, different methods of data collection. So different type of data collection will produce a different format of spatial data. Some in the point cloud, some in the image, some in the vector, some need some further processing before we can use it. So this data need to be corrected and manipulated to be processed before we can use it in our system. So some issues in this data input is, how we're going to input that data, and then if they use different projections, maybe from WGS we want to use in our own coordinate system, we need to project, reproject, and then we're going to generalize from complex to simpler method. So maybe we get some drawing from engineering department, and then we're going to use it in our system, we need to generalize. So we're going to simplify this data. And then lastly is the mesh and joining adjacent map. So we have two type of map that is sitting which is other, and then how we're going to match this data between this, from these two type of map. Okay, so this is some of the example. We have sources from the map, from the previous map. Maybe we have some basic data topographic map from the different from the previous our center maybe. Okay, so we need to digitize all this map. And then if we have the satellite data, we need to scan it first and then process to put it inside our own projection. And then we have other digital data, we're going to that make a data transfer, and maybe we also have a tabular data that have only maybe a address, and then we need to have some processing before we can put inside our system. And then some other soft idea, so we need to key code all this idea to pinpoint where the location is, and then what the input that we're going to put inside that. So we need to do some key coding. Then all of this is a data capture or data collection. So all this data after that need to be editing or clean up. Maybe they have some error, they have some redundant, maybe so many type of error can be done by human, by the system itself, by the scan map, and so on. And then maybe we need to do the reprojection. So and then we need to generalize all this data, and then maybe we need to do some edge matching and rubber sheeting. We will discuss later on in this topic, and then we need to layer. So this data will be included in this layer, or we need to divide it into two different layer, and then after that we will have some integrated JS database. So this is the throughout our topic today. Okay, so the data input. So the method of data input, previously we discussed the data sources, the source of data from GPS, from LiDAR, from satellite, from GPS and so on. So this is how we're going to input all this data into our system. So the data format will be in digital and analog. We have still have the old map, maybe the hard copy map, we have still analog. So data in GIS, as we know, we have the spatial data and also the attribute data. So this data needs some conversion. So the methods is, in this topic we discuss only four methods. The first one is the keyboard entry. The second one is manual digitizing. The third one is automatic digitizer, and the last one is electronic data transfer. Okay, so we will discuss each of this method later on. Okay, the first one. So the first one is the keyboard entry. So the keyboard entry means that we have some maybe tabular data, some table from other person. Okay, they want us to put all this data. Maybe they have already have the location inside the all the point, all the line, all the polygon is already collected. So they need to have some data to keyboard, data from the tabular or the attribute data. So this is where the keyboard entry is known as the first method. So we insert data using keyboard, as we know lah, we only going to type it, and then usually for table or tabular data, maybe demographic, house pricing and so on. So the issue is with the typographical error, means that if different person that didn't have some knowledge on that particular topic or field, maybe they will key in a different type of input. For example, we have city, C-I-T-Y, and then maybe they lazy or so on, maybe they forgot, we sleepy, we type C-I-T-I. So there's some of the issue with this method. So each data have their own code or key. So this is one of the method or technique to reduce the typographical error. So even our name itself, we have so many type of different type of version. Even my name, Zakri, Z-A-K-R-Y, Z-A-K-R-I. So they need to have some key code or note or key or code to make this data entry quite easier. Okay, simple one, I think, the first one. So the second one is the manual digitizing. So this is the first previous, maybe in 1980s, 1970s, 1980s, 1960s, they're using manual digitizing. So previously they don't have the scanning technologies. So the manual digitizing is they do the digitizing process, but they will use the hard copy map and using a digitizing table. Okay, and then this digitizing table have some cursor or mouse. They call it cursor, not a mouse. So they have two type mode, point mode and stream mode. Point mode means that 1 point, 2 point, click by click is one is a point. Stream mode is they will connect between this point. So it will require a very high skill person to do this manual digitizing. So this is the example from late 80s. So I also use this tablet or table digitizing table. So this is the cursor, it's like a mouse. Okay, they have some cursor like this, some crosshair over here. Okay, to pinpoint where's the area we're going to digitize, and then we will put our map over here, the big map. So this is the biggest map, the size AO, I think AO lah. Okay, and then they will connect with the computer, and then they will digitize. So you need to, the first we need to do the geocoded first, geocoding, georeference of this map, and then we're going to digitize based on information inside the map. So they will use the hard copy map. We will staple over here, Okay, and after that they do some correction, and then we can do the digitizing part. So this is the manual digitizing. Okay, so the accuracy depend on the map scale. So if they have bigger scale, they will go will more accurate. And then the quality of equipment also, if they have high end equipment, they will give more accuracy. Then the software that you use in correct registration, if you don't have the correct registration, means that how we going to register the coordinate, maybe the map will be the output is the upside down. So this is some issue with this manual digitizing. And then shaky hand, if you have shaky hand, you cannot do the manual digitizing, the data will be haywire after that. So after that, there's no more, currently no more. Maybe you yourself didn't even see this table digitizing. So all this our current practice is using the digital automatic digitizing. We can scan the map and then we use the we make the digitizing in our computer only. Okay, so the third one is the automatic digitizer. So this is the improvement of the previous one. So the previous method is the manual digitizing. So this is automatic digitizer. So the map will be scanned using scanner. Okay, and then all this method we also known as on-screen digitizing. Okay, need to consider the output format. Is it layers or image processing? And then it will based on the type of scanner, flatbed or roller. So this is two type of scanner. The left one is the flatbed. This is the roller. So you will put your map over here and then we scan. It will show you the result over here. So this is the flatbed that we currently use daily. So we put all the map, but the limitation is the size is maximum is A3, I think. So if higher A0, A1, so you need to use the roller bed scan. And then after that, after you scan, you will digitize based on the layer that you going to digitize lah. Okay, you select the process, okay, and then you digitize it in your screen. So that's all. That's why they call it on screen digitizing. Okay. So some issue optical distortion, maybe your scanner have some problem in distortion, and then the scanning unwanted information such as maybe your hair, maybe your hair is suddenly fall down in your scanner, and then they scan it. So and then you will get some line that don't have any attribute. You don't know what is it. Okay, and then they have also the scanning tolerance, the resolution based on your scanner. And then the file format and also the amount of editing you need to do. So this is some issue in the third methods, automatic digitizing. So this is the popular method still used until today. Okay, the last one is formatted of data input is the electronic data transfer. So this is where we get some data from other agency, other organization, other person. Okay, you get data of even you collect your own data using GPS receiver or total station. So you need to convert this data into GIS ready format. Okay, so they involve more cost to conversion maybe. So if you use other agency just use it as it is using the format that they use. So the conversion will take time and maybe the processing will take more cost and person to do the editing. Okay, this is example of electronic data transfer. So this is the drawing from the AutoCAD. Then this is data from GPS. So they will give you the waypoint, okay, the location X and Y, but they don't have any attribute. Also this drawing also don't have any attribute. So you need to select which layer you want to convert, and then after conversion you need to do some editing part lah. Okay, so this is other, this one, the left one is the data from UAV drone. So this is a UTM area in our Tasik Ilmu. If you're going to UTM, if you have some opportunity to come to UTM, you can see this is the lake, the famous lake of Tasik Ilmu. Okay, and then you have also LiDAR. So LiDAR is point cloud data. So you need to have some conversion to after that to use it in GIS. Alright, so this is a discussion on the data input, the methods of data input. So they have four data methods of data input. The first one is keyboard entry, so it's still used. Second one is the manual digitizing, currently not being used anymore. So the third one is automatic digitizing, so this is currently we use in our also in our lab. And lastly is electronic data transfer, means that you have data from other sources and then you need to convert it into GIS ready data. Okay, the next one is the data editing. So data, as we already discussed, so each data they will have some error. Okay, so because data from different sources, okay, maybe you derive data, you make some analysis and process, and then you make another pinpoint maybe, and then they have some inaccuracy or uncertainty attribute data. And so you also want to some input some new attribute data and affecting data the quality. So they need to have some cleaning or cleanup process. So this is where the data editing part come in. Okay, so method of data editing, the first one is detecting and correcting error, the topology actually. So the undershoot, overshoot over here, and then maybe you need to do some reprojection from WGS to Cassini, or maybe WGS to Arriso, or maybe from Arriso to Cassini. So different projection, so need to have there some transformation and generalization. And then the third one is the edge meshing and rubber sheeting. This is some very good data editing part, because if you use some different coordinate system, you will shift the data a little bit, so you need to do some shifting editing part. And then lastly, the geocoding address data. So this is some of data editing. Okay, the first one is a detecting and correcting error. So data, the error is in data source when encoding, propagate, using, transfer and conversion. So the spatial data is harder to detect, maybe some redundant same line, they redundant maybe 3 to 4 times. So I have seen this type of error. So you cannot select, so you need to select by the attribute. So you need to do some error checking in the attribute lah. Or maybe you can do some topology checking. And then the attribute data easy to detect, because you can see the error, the typing error and so on, so you can have to see it. So source data, spatial data is quite harder. So error while encoding, the overshoot, the undershoot, for raster, they have some noise, maybe some cloud in the data. So the common error in spatial data, missing entities, duplicate entities, mislocated entities, should be over here, should be in error, they put it over the other way. And then missing labels, duplicate labels, two or more identify level for the same polygon, artifact of digitizing, undershoot, overshoot, place node wrongly and so on. So noise, irrelevant data during digitizing, scanning or data transfer. As I said, maybe your hair is inside there, so you need to do some editing part lah. Okay, the second one is the reprojection, transformation and generalization. So this is will be affected by scale and resolution. They need the coordinate transformation, so they have some distortion, need offset setting. So the method of transform is translate and scaling, common origin, create or common origin and rotation. So maybe you need to rotate your map later on. So this is some example. So the because different coordinate system using different method formula, so maybe they have some shifting. So if you need to reproject, you need to do some projection part. So we will discuss later on in our lab on this part lah. Okay, the third one is edge matching and rubber sheeting. If you have two type of map side by side, so they will have some mismatch maybe, and then they also have some topology error, so need some editing of edge matching and rubber sheeting. So this is so the first one is the mismatch, not the first one, okay, the mismatch of data editing when you combine two or more map. So I will show you later on. Edge line not match between each other, need to resolve to reduce topological error. Okay, because the critical different type between two feature in edge. Some topology, edge have distortion for vector or map, photogrammetry or satellite data image have distortion, especially a tall building. So So if you see, this is some editing process I need to do. So this is some issue. You put two map side by side by the edge. So you need to do some adjustment because this is the error. So you need to shift a little bit the sheet B a little bit higher so you can mesh between each feature. So this is what we call it edge matching. So this is some editing technique lah, okay, in GIS. And rubber sheeting. So we have over here, look over here, they have two line, the same line, okay. And then the other sign, the other data from maybe from other coordinate system, so they need to do some shifting. So you need to drag this line to the new line that corrected, okay. Okay, so this is some example of edge matching and rubber sheeting. Okay, the last one on the data editing is geocoding address data. It's a process to convert address to point location. Means that you have an address, so you're going to pinpoint that address into the exact location with the X and Y coordinate. So usually using by post office and navigation. So the issue is in spelling, in the format, and in abbreviation. So this is some issue lah in geocoding address data. So here is example, if you search for C02 UTM, they will pinpoint this is the building. So this is how they do it, we do not know, because this is from the Google platform, and the algorithm is from Google. So if you interested, you can do some research on this, on geocoding part. So they have, so maybe you have your own address you want to do. So you will geocode your address into the pinpoint X and Y location. So currently the conversion will be only as a point lah, not a polygon or line. So that's a geocoding address data. So all this data, we need some integrated database. So you need to integrate. So means that even though you have so many type of data, we'll put inside one database. So with integrated database, it will have connection between different data spatial databases. But to resolve some issue, the coordinate system, datum, policy and standard. So means that maybe you have so many type of databases, different type of projection, coordinate system, you need to integrate. You need to do some process first before you can integrate this database. But later on, after you finish create this database, you can use and you can transfer this data into different type of application. So it will be very easy later on. Okay, maybe hard to do the first process to reproject, correct, edge matching and so on. But after you have this integrated database, you can have different type of format and so on later on based on the requirement. So that's the importance of integrated database. So in Malaysia, we have currently we already changed it into Pusat Geospatial Negara, so National Geospatial Center. So in Malaysia, we have one center to lead the this process lah, the data sharing and also integrated spatial data. And then we have MyGDI, Malaysia Geospatial Data Infrastructure. So it's an infrastructure to facilitate data sharing. So we have so many type of agency has so many type of format. So MyGDI will help them to integrate all this data into one main database, and then after that we can use this data for different purpose. So in Malaysia we have it, and most of the most of the country like Australia, US, Canada, UK, Europe already developed their own SDI or Geospatial Data Infrastructure or Spatial Data Infrastructure. Okay, so this is the framework. Okay, MyGDI is the national level. So SDI is Spatial Data Infrastructure or Geospatial Data Infrastructure. This one is to enable data sharing between agency and organization. They have several level. So from local to state, to national, to regional and global. So we have global SDI and then regional. So in Malaysia, Malaysia area not yet, but Europe they have it regional. And then national is MyGDI lah, where's the MyGDI is places. Okay, so as a conclusion, we discuss on the method of spatial data input. and then we discuss later. Also data editing and issue related to it, and then the overview of process to create an integrated GIS database, and then show the issue of data input and editing and how to resolve the issue, because 50% to 80% of time in developing GIS is for data encoding and editing. So this is some discussion we discuss in this topic. So hopefully you understand. If you have some issue, you can ask me. So that's all from me. Thank you very much. Assalamualaikum. Terima kasih. Thank you.